Jamboheim Gary Broom, Associated Press Championship Week would be incomplete without a few blind resume comparisons to help determine whether teams like Louisville, Syracuse and USC actually belong in the NCAA Division I men's basketball tournament. The purpose of the exercise is to strip away the team names and the proverbial eye test to focus solely upon what the computer numbers have to say. Oftentimes, blind resumes intentionally give you just a portion of the picture in order to trick you into thinking a certain team is in much better or worse shape than it actually is. But no tricks or games here. These are all teams that are squarely on the bubble and whom the committee might be comparing head-to-head at this moment. No one is going to lament the plight of the poor bracketologist, but let me just tell you that this is easily the toughest bubble I have ever encountered. In most seasons, we are debating between maybe 5 teams for the final 2 spots in the 68-team field. But this year, the difference between the top projected No. 10 seed and the 5th team out is razor thin. It doesn't help matters that we've got this new quadrant system instead of the tried-and-true RPI Top 50 and RPI Top 100 buckets of yore. The only evidence we have of how the committee is using this newly structured information is the top 16 reveal from February, where Q1 wins seemed to be gold and Q3, Q4 losses were landmines. For the uninitiated, these are the quadrants. Q1, home versus RPI Top 30, neutral versus RPI Top 50, road versus RPI Top 75, Q2, home versus RPI 31-75, neutral versus RPI 51-100, road versus RPI 76-135, Q3, home versus RPI 76-160, neutral versus RPI 101-200, road versus RPI 136-240, Q4, home versus RPI 161-351, neutral versus RPI 201-351, road versus RPI 241-351. With that information, let's dive into the bubble. Comparison No. 1 Team A, 23-7, RPI 32, KenPom 49, SOS 87, NCSOS 8, Q1 record 3-3, Q3, Q4 record 18-3, Team B 28-5, RPI 40, KenPom 28, SOS 168, NCSOS 183, Q1 record 2-1, Q3, Q4 record 24-2. In case it isn't blatantly obvious from the high win totals and the high number of Q3, Q4 games, we are looking at a pair of mid-major teams. And from that information alone, if you've been paying any attention to the bubble for the past few days, you probably know who we're talking about. But play along anyway, we're not necessarily saying the selection committee only has room for one of these teams. They could both get in. The more likely scenario is that they both get left out. But because it's mathematically challenging to compare minor conference resumes to major conference ones, this is a crucial pecking order to make in case the committee decides to invite just one little guy. The part of this comparison that really jumps off the page is the non-conference strength of schedule. Team A clearly made a committed effort to challenge itself with quality competition, while Team B sat at home and got fat on cream puffs. For all their trouble, Team A only got one Quadrant 1 win and one Quadrant 2 win, but that's a heck of a lot better than Team B, which acquired a Quadrant 2 win and a Quadrant 3 loss. But there's one big feather in Team B's cap. One of its Quadrant 1 wins came on the road against a team projected for a number 4 or no. All three of Team A's Quadrant 1 wins were on the road, but not one of them came against a legitimate at-large candidate. The Rival E. Baskow, Associated Press. Team A is Middle Tennessee, and Team B is St. Mary's. That outstanding road win for the Gales was the 74-71 comeback victory at Gonzaga. And for MTSU, the wins were at Murray State, at Western Kentucky and at Old Dominion. A lot of folks have been going to bat for St. Mary's by arguing about the eye test and the fact that the Gales have strong ranks on the advanced metrics like KenPom.com, but here's a nugget for you. Middle Tennessee lost neutral court games to USC and Miami and a road game against Auburn by a combined margin of 14 points. The Blue Raiders were right there away from home against quality opponents, almost doesn't count, but will that many almosts matter to the selection committee? And will it matter that MTSU's 2 worst losses of the season came in its 2 most recent games? Comparison No. 2 Team C, 22-10, RPI, 33, KenPom, 42, SOS, 50, NCSOS, 60, Q1 record, 4-5, Q3, Q4 record, 13-1 Team D, 19-14, RPI, 87, KenPom, 54, SOS, 48, NCSOS, 291, Q1 record, 5-12, Q3, Q4 record, 10-0 at a passing glance, this one is a no-brainer. It's Team C every day and twice on Selection Sunday, but if you dig into the minutiae as much as we are led to believe the selection committee does, it's a much closer call. Let's start with the Q1 record. How many of those games were actually impressive? Team C only played 2 games against KenPom's top 40 teams, losing by 16-0. 30 and losing by 14-0.